Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Friday, November 12th, 2010. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback on this video. Please leave a comment when you are done watching, even if you just say hi or thanks. I would really appreciate that. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day, and we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a 15-minute chart without indicators for the euro-yen currency pair as it looked at the open of today's New York session on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform. Well, the rumor mill was definitely churning today. First, there was speculation that the central bank in China may be forced to hike rates following a higher-than-expected CPI print for October. Now, that weighed on the yen crosses as today's Asian session was winding down. Then sentiment flipped during the London session on circulating rumors of an 80 billion euro rescue package from the IMF for Ireland. That appeared to spark some euro short covering, which gave the euro a lift against the major currencies, including, of course, the Japanese yen, as you see here. Although traders have been shorting the euro much of this week on concerns about Ireland, they were ill-advised to fight that Irish bailout rumor mill most of the European trading day. However, there was one more technical opportunity to short the euro against both the yen and against the dollar as the European trading week neared its close. I used a one-hour chart without indicators, much like this one, in front of the live class to identify at least one source of resistance which might have some bearing on today's euro-yen price action. Now, the main thing that caught my eye was a trend line based on a series of four swing lows and two swing highs. I've just identified those swing lows and swing highs with blue arrows here. Okay, let's now connect those arrows with a black line. I didn't discuss it until later in the coaching session, but there was also a case you made for another trend line based on a pair of lows formed late last week plus the highs from the past two trading days. I've just labeled all those with blue arrows, and now let's connect those with a blue trend line. Okay, now let's zoom in on this chart for a closer look at today's price action. Looking on the upper right-hand portion of this chart, you see this thin horizontal maroon-colored line that I'm now identifying with the blue arrow? That's the daily R1 pivot point, meaning it's a resistance pivot point, and it appears to be sitting near at least two other prospective sources of resistance, namely the two trend lines we added earlier to this chart. Now, because all those come together around the 113.35 area, that area around near 113.35 could represent a profit target for traders who long this pair earlier today. Now let me be clear. At this point, the euro yen has made its biggest move since the Japan intervention in mid-September. Shorting in this context wasn't for the novice trader or the faint of heart, especially when a U.S. consumer sentiment report was released just minutes before the euro yen reaches that 113.35 area. Let's advance the chart forward in time by 1 hour. On the upper right-hand portion of this chart, there's the touch of the 113.35 area, two trend lines plus daily R1, minutes after the release of that U.S. report. However, in this case, the U.S. news didn't deliver any surprises, plus yesterday's high. Looking back over here, there's yesterday's high. Yesterday's high was just 20 pips above today's R1 pivot point. So if you took the short at or near the daily R1 pivot point, you could have limited your risk by closing trade if this pair rose above yesterday's high. Moving forward in time. Although it wasn't a big winner, the short trade did work. If you exited the trade at London close, which I recall was right here, the close of the green candle I'm not pointing to, if you close the trade at London close, you earned a profit of about 40 pips. Okay, I'll wrap up this video with a quick look at the short trade setup for the Euro USD. On the left is a 4-hour chart for the U.S. Dollar Index Futures December contract, which we commonly refer to as the DX, and on the right is a 15-minute chart for the Euro-USD. On the left here on the DX, as the DX was testing an uptrend support line here, based on a series of higher lows beginning on November 4th, the Euro-USD on the right, the Euro-USD was testing its daily R1 pivot point. Now, ironically enough, the Euro-USD put in its high for the day at its R1 pivot point at the same time as the Euro-Yen did the same thing at its own R1 pivot point. Now, there was roughly 110 pips of profit to be had from that short trade down on the Euro-USD for those who held it about an hour after London close. Now, that move down ended near the 136.60 level. You can see the balance right there at 136.60. That level happened to serve as resistance earlier today. As you can see, the swing highs formed here during the earlier part of the trading day. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Friday, November 12th.